Okay, well, I haven't really been anywhere noteworthy or mentionable.
The Secret Life of Walter Mitty divided a lot of critics upon its release in theaters, many saying that the movie lacked originality and depth. After watching a film with friends, I'm usually the one in the group that points out all the flaws as soon as the lights come back on. I don't go into the theater wanting to dislike a film, it just seems to happen a lot. But occasionally I'll see a movie that critics didn't love, but touched me in some way where I just can't complain much about it. The Secret Life of Walter Mitty is one of those films. Objectively speaking, this movie could have been much better.
What are you doing here?
Mom made you your favorite clementine cake.
Aren't you supposed to be at the retirement place with her getting the piano moved in?
But I think it touched the minds of a lot of people and its overall theme. Its message about stopping the daydreams and actually going out and experiencing the world resonated with its audience. A lot of people feel like they are trapped in their jobs and can't ever escape to go live their lives away from a cubicle. This is why many people could relate to Walter Mitty. Many of us continuously do a job that we don't love under a boss we can't stand. We all know what it's like to daydream, and we all know what it's like to make excuses instead of putting action to words. When Walter finally steps out and starts his adventure, there's this sense of relief and happiness. A feeling of, yes, he did it. It gives us hope. Hope that one day we will build up the courage to go to the places we've only seen in pictures. Places where we can get lost on purpose and not come back for weeks. We've all thought about taking a spontaneous trip to a new place and having an adventure, but how many of us actually act on that impulse? I think the best part about this movie is that the theme isn't really about traveling. The theme focuses on what's truly important in life. Adventures are wonderful, but adventures without someone to share it with are much less fulfilling.
This one goes out to Walter Mitty. He knows why.
Walter comes back to Cheryl because this movie is about relationships. We want to accomplish our dreams beside the person we care about the most. Life is an adventure, and that adventure is supposed to be shared with the special people around you. Ground control to Major Tom. As a structured story, The Secret Life of Walter Mitty missed the mark of becoming the great film it could have been. But emotionally, it landed. It hit people in a way that made them look up just how much plane tickets to Iceland would cost, or how many hours it would actually take to drive to Yosemite. It pushed people closer to the reality that their job isn't the only thing that exists in the world, nor is it the most important. This movie made me say, I get that, I want to be there, I want to do that, I understand what it's like to be a daydreamer. It was refreshing to me, a person who spends a good portion of his time watching poorly rebooted blockbusters. If you enjoyed this movie, it's because you got the big idea. You got what Ben Stiller was trying to say. Sure, it wasn't perfect, but you got the message and it touched you. A movie doesn't have to be a perfect masterpiece for it to impact you. Sometimes a film will just speak to you, and sometimes it will make you act. This movie has one message: get off the couch, grab somebody you care about, and hit the road. And if this movie inspired you to do that, then it succeeded. The only thing stopping you is you. This is ground control. You've really